Hello everyone and welcome back to some awesome racing. Today we are on iRacing in the Blancpain GT3 Sprint Series. Just driving the Audi as my phone decides it'll go for a bit of a walk. There, come on. We will be doing a 40 minute race around the Ring GP. This is the NZ SOF. Can't see, I didn't do too bad in the way of qualifying against some of these fairly quick guys. Qualify 12th. Probably could have done better, but I'll stick with it. Turn the guys up front doing 51s. And not slow cookies for that matter. As everybody's checking up here, this is not getting well. It's green. Alright, let's go for it. As far as I can tell, pace is fairly good this week. Half feels pretty good as well. And off track, okay. Way to go. Ooh, that was close. Whoa! Look out. That's a car deciding it wants to do gymnastics. And instead be an aeroplane at the same time. It's not quite a jumbo jet, but it's definitely a lightweight aircraft. As far as I can tell, I think we're in the top 10. I'm not too sure. Yes, we are top 10, I thought so. That clock might get a bit of a check up there. Seems to be in different places. End of the day, GT3 gonna GT3? Because that's what GT3 do. Those cars provide good racing and have very strong fields. Considering it's the most popular one of the most popular series, if not the most popular series out there. there. Sound of crunching metal, oh, lovely. Saw that, my Maris. The pace is there, but the pace isn't there. Yeah. It's just so close that, yeah. Just can't seem to get close enough to make a move. Anyway, if I did, it probably wouldn't stick too well. As I just casually save it. Normally that ends in a spin doing that sort of thing. I'm actually amazed that actually stayed straight. This race is also broadcast, and I'll leave the replay of that live stream in the description. Just some slight understeer there. Not a lot in it. Customs, she does strange things. Moment. Not sure if it's weather orientated, but Maybe. I didn't do this in the other race, so I did the stuff yesterday. Oh, actually, a few hours before this race. Which, ironically, I was in a race with Richie Stanaway in that one. So it's good to compare. See how quick he actually is. Was driving the Mercedes, I'm not sure how many times he's driven it before, but he seemed to be pretty decent, but yeah. He unfortunately made the mistake of underfueling in the pit stop, which was actually quite funny, to be fairly honest, but quite unfortunate, as it was quite a good little battle we had going on. Whoops, slightly too early on the turn in. Now, if this race is anything like the one I was in with Stanaway, my car's gonna come on later in the race, as the field drops off, which is going to be good. And the Mercedes in front of me will lose pace because of it, because the tyre's going off. Not sure if it's weather, that's a weather thing, but definitely seems to feel like it. Starting to lose time on the guy's head. currently, I seem to be getting stuck in these situations quite a lot. Very recently, where I'm chasing on the cars ahead, and I've got a guy behind me who's chasing me down as well. And the difference between the two gaps to the car in front and behind, it doesn't really change. Usually it's the other way around, the guy behind gain time on the guys ahead I lose time on. Not really the way you want it to go, but that's kind of racing. The spotter just briefly dropping the F-bomb. Because Jimmy Johnson's spotter back. That car kind of cost me a little bit of speed coming out of turn one there. Just primarily on the line-out thing. Still managed to get past that hitting him, but yeah, kind of just annoyed me a little bit. Okay. Just don't want to shift down to third because it just kills the momentum. May have to start doing so. Just slightly too early on the gas. Hate when that happens. You're so tempted to do it, but yeah. Just screws you over when you do. Thank you. That was close. Just a wee bit of compression lock and rear braking lock. Kinda hate when it happens, even though I've got the max front, but I can on the brake bias. Still tends to do it from time to time. Bit of a bummer, I've lost the pack ahead of me. End of the day, I'll be happy with the top 10 to be fairly honest. Especially with the strength of field that it is of over 3,000. And considering pretty much everybody in front of me is fairly quick, I'm not gonna complain. Someone's in the pits. Oh yeah, ninth place. Flip your bitch. Buttery curbs! Well, that's better for 10th, just got more intense. 9th or 10th, depending on whether that guy that pitted it, who was 9th, was scheduled. Ah, yeah, Bruno. Now, I got a Mercedes all over my rear end, lovely. been a bit unbalanced here. Oh dear. Best end disconnected as well. Yes, I'm quite aware of recent server issues people have been having, as I did encounter myself in the race. That I was in with Stanaway. So I didn't qualify on that race yet, still managed to finish about 6th, somewhere like that. Definitely top 10. So I guess I can't completely complain about that. But I'll say it now, I don't know, I've said it on the forum, and I'll say it again. If it happens during the race, the dumps it, like, a huge amount of people out, then I think there's gonna be a riot or two over that, because yeah, nobody wants to get disconnected from a 24-hour race when you're only a few hours into a race, or even, or that matter of fact, past halfway, if it did happen after halfway. All that time, effort, maybe money. And brain power gone. Down the plug hole. Go one more, got plenty. Say about 5 laps worth. Oh, not quite, maybe 4 laps worth of fuel by the time we get around into the pits. Bloody throttle, freaking weight transfer annoyance crap. Riley's in the box, and we'll definitely need a pit stop because I ain't gonna make it on less than 3 litres. It's been the pit lane, I've done that before and it's really annoying. yeah, 4 laps will do, actually. Yeah, that'll do. I think two of those guys are getting me. I think Paul and Gustavo are yet to pit, actually. Or maybe not. No, actually, I think they... oh yeah, hold on. I think they do, because they weren't ahead of me before. Hey, well, if they actually have already pitted, oh. Bloody oath. Bloody oath on the, what's it called? Undercut, that's what it is. Oh no, they were, yeah. So maybe, Xav was ahead of me. Oh no, Gustavo did need a pit, I thought so. Would have still shuffling from pit stops. Actually, I didn't check it what my tyres look like. Oh yeah, not too bad. Three positions? Yes, please. Ball's not so dry, right, so may catch up and mix quite an interesting battle. Not sure. I know the two ahead of me are fairly quick. Especially Mr. Scuderia. Too overly fussed about the off tracks. I'm getting back to safe riding in the 24 hours of Daytona. Ninth. Sweet. Happy with that. Well, that's a bit of understeer. Please white flag, please white flag. Shoot. Ah, crap. That pulls all over my ass. Uh-oh. It's gonna be close! I'm looking at it going, oh. Uh-oh. It's gonna be really, really close. If you'll indicate it, it's going. It's slow. Uh-oh. We got a big problem. A very big problem. Fuel pressure's dropping. Quicker than I can blink. Nope, don't throw it away, don't throw it away. No! Oh, come on! We crossed the line! You gotta be kidding me. Cross the line, it coughs. I knew I underfold. There's like no There's no pressure left. Just like 7.5. And she's out. That pisses me off.
Sorry for the tap. Did you run out of fuel?
That just okay. Sucks.
Be careful, Philip, on these engine
lines. It just coughed slightly too early. There was literally a nose in it, literally nothing in it. The difference being 4,000. Dear. That sucks. That really does suck. Oh, I still got a top 10 though. Pretty stoked with that, to be fairly honest. Bit of bang crashing going on. Actually pretty clean to be fairly honest. Oh, there's a car from the distance. Behind us. Way! Oh, that's right. I wanted to see this. Oh dear. How did this happen? Ah, yeah. Some just moved across. Yeah, some just moved across and, well, to be fairly honest. Let's be honest here. You're off the racing circuit. That's kinda Simon's fault. If I'm fairly honest. He kinda caused that. It's actually quite funny driving past it, to be fairly honest, but oh well. Oh well. I'll settle for a top 10. Especially in a strength and field race like that. Thank you guys for the video, and I'll see you next time for hopefully some even more epic racing.